Hello guys, welcome back to another interesting tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to tell you in depth that how we can show certain folds and crease lines in the garments and also how we can use pencil colors to blend the folds. This is part one of the series. I will be posting more such videos to show different kind of folds and falls in the garment of different silhouettes and fabrics. So I will explain this rendering using this reference picture. I'm not going to give a realistic approach to this illustration, but I will show you how I give the folds and the crease lines in the garment, and you can see the picture and then you can compare it with my illustration here. You can see that the total length is 5 inch, and this is also how you can practice yourself. Just pick up the garments and then you can practice your own rendering. Now the important question is how to give the folds. Here you can see that I am using my pencil only to show the certain fold lines, and the picture which you are referring, pick out the major fold lines. I mean, don't see the picture overall, but just go part by part and just draw the major fold lines in your drawing, and later we will do the rendering using pencil colors only. So guys, before I move to the pencil rendering, I would like to show you certain important things which you need to remember when you are drawing with your pencil color. With the amount of your pressure, you can easily manipulate the strokes. Like when you put too much pressure, you give the dark strokes, and then you can use less pressure for the light strokes and for the medium strokes, and lastly you can do your gradation. That means either it's going from the lightest to the darkest or darkest to the lightest. So yes, this is how you can practice your own pencil stroke separately, and you can practice the fold lines and everything, and later you can move to your main illustrations, and with your practice you can easily master over this. So first thing first, I will give a base color to this illustration. I mean a very light wash of the color which you can see in this picture. I mean the lightest shade. So guys, either you can use watercolor or you can use your Staedtler pencil colors to do the watercolor effect, but I am giving watercolor here, and this is totally up to you which medium you can choose to give the base color. I will show another one where I will be using brush markers to give the base. So here you can see that in the picture there are some highlighted area. I mean this is the part where it is curved out or there are certain folds. So there will be light falling on those areas and we can see the lightest tone of that base color. So this is what we are going to do. Now, leaving the area blank where you see the white highlights, use your pencil color to give the strokes only in the areas where you see the darker tones. You can see how I'm doing it, and using a combination of your base pencil color and some black, you can do that. Also guys, make sure that the pencil color which you are using is quite similar to your base color. I mean if there is a contrast in the shades or the tones of your pencil color, it will look little odd. I mean the blending will not be proper and we can see the pencil strokes easily, and we don't want that. We want a very smooth blending. So guys, now go back to the first thing which I said you about pencil colors, that how with our own pressure of the hand we can manipulate the strokes. I mean if we give very high pressure there will be high strokes, and if we give very light pressure there will be very smooth lines. So this is totally up to you and your hand how you are giving the pressure, and you have to study the reference picture very well, and then you can manipulate your strokes using the same pencil color. A very important tip is that when you are little confused that how to start the blending or how to give the folds, just start by giving the fold lines. Here you can see that I have used my pencil color to give the strokes whichever I can make out from the picture. I mean, it's not always totally possible for us to draw everything very exact like in the picture, and this totally depends how you see the picture and how you manipulate it, but at least we can try to make out something from the picture and give the folds like how it is. So here you can see, first I am drawing the fold lines with my pencil color, and then I am using some light strokes and some dark strokes. Use black in the areas where you see the darker tones. That will be beneath the fold lines or at the corners, and this will be in the areas where there is very little light. And here you can see that I am using the eraser to give the folds a little more highlight. So guys, I hope you can understand that how I am doing this. I mean, first I am giving the fold lines and the strokes towards the direction to which the fold lines is going, which is very important. I mean, we have to show in the garment that on which direction it is going, and also the fold lines indicate that the garment is how tightly fitted or how loosely fitted. So don't worry about that. I will be saying more on folds and rendering in my upcoming videos. Also, make sure your pencil is sharpened well, otherwise you won't be getting this kind of detailed rendering and the lines, especially using the black pencil. The eraser plays a very important role, which you can use to erase out the parts where there is lots of highlights. I mean, you can see in the garment and how I'm using the eraser to erase out my pencil strokes there. So yes, and make sure your eraser is very tiny or very fine to give this kind of precise erasing. So guys, I hope you understood now that why I gave a light base color of the watercolor. That part indicates the very lightest tone in the garment, and I'm leaving that area and I'm using pencil strokes in the other areas. So all this together will come up very nicely and will show the depth in your garment. So guys, I hope you are enjoying this tutorial and you came to know about this technique, and I would love to see your recreations and how you are using this technique in your own illustrations. So do post your artworks on Instagram and tag me in your works, and also use this hashtag, which will be easier for me to find out your works and keep a track of them. So guys, my blending is completed, and the final step or an optional step can be to blend everything nicely with a white pencil. I'm using Faber-Castell Polychromos white pencil. It works good for me, and I don't know if the Staedtler white pencil does this kind of justice because I don't have the white pencil in the Staedtler range, so I use this pencil, or you can use erasers to blend, and also you can use tissue papers also to blend over this. And lastly, it totally depends how smooth was your pencil strokes. I shall quickly talk about the papers, that on which kind of paper this kind of pencil blending looks good. And the one which I'm using right now is nothing fancy. I am using a normal art copy from the Classmate range worth rupees 50, which I got from the local stores. You can also use ivory sheets. Ivory sheets are very good for pencil works. Or you can use papers which are very smooth in texture, and I will be posting the links of the materials and the Amazon links below. You can go and check them out. Let us move to the next one. In this picture, you can see that the blending is very smooth. Unlike the previous one, there are no crease lines in this one, and there are folds at the waist point which are going downwards. Also, you can see the gradation from the darkest tone to the lightest is very smooth. So this is what we are going to achieve now. For the base color, I am using Camlin brush pens in the shade red, and you can use any other medium as well, like watercolor or poster color. I will be showing with those mediums as well in my next video of this series. So guys, I gave a very smooth surface using this brush pen, and here we can't understand that where are the fold lines and everything, but don't worry, we will show that with our pencil colors. And now I'm using pencil colors from the Polychromos range. First, I'm giving some strokes using the red, and using colors like gray and black, we will bring this gradation in the depth in the garment. The gray is a very interesting color which helps us to balance the shadows in our garment. So before moving to the black directly, I'm using very light strokes of the gray pencil to divide my folds here. Also, I'm using the white pencil in the areas where I see lots of lights falling on the curve of the fold. And I will use the red immediately over it. So this is a very nice trick, that whenever you find the white strokes overpowering it too much, you can use your base color pencil to lightly shade out on the white, and this is how you can balance the white strokes in your garments. Here you can see how the look is changing slowly just by giving some light strokes of the gray pencil and using white at the center wherever you see the light falling over the garment. So that's why it's very important to have a very smooth and even blending of the base color. I mean, if your base color is not properly done, the pencil strokes will not come out nicely. So make sure whichever base color you are doing has to be very even, and there should not be much texture on the base color. And now I will give the darkest shadows using the black. And also guys, you can see how I'm using both the pencil colors, I mean the black and the gray, to blend the shadows very properly. I mean, after you are done with your black shade, move to the gray to blend the black very nicely. So just repeat this step until you are satisfied. The direction of your strokes matters a lot. I mean, here you can see the fall of the garment which is going downwards. There is lots of flares, and so when you are using your strokes, go in the similar direction to give the equal look whichever you can see in the picture. Again, guys, I would like to tell you that the pressure of your strokes matters a lot while doing this kind of smooth blending. I mean, you have to manipulate yourself very nicely and how you are perceiving the picture and how you are putting it down on your paper. So yes, with practice and time, you will totally master over this. And I hope all my tips are being useful to everyone. So guys, I hope you can understand that how gray plays a very important role in showing this kind of dark shadows in a garment. I mean, using the black may not be always that fruitful, but using the gray pencil along with the black can bring a major difference. Lastly, I would like to say that my intention was not to give a realistic approach to these illustrations. I used this picture not to copy it exactly, but just to make you understand that how we can study a garment picture and use that in our illustration to give the high tones, mid tones, and to do the blending. So yes, you can also take reference picture and practice like this. I hope you enjoyed today's session, and if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe it. I will see you all soon. Till then, keep practicing and take care.